वंदे गुजरात।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर नीरज कुमार सिंह, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट श्री ए एन पटेल पीजी इंस्टीट्यूट एफिलिएटेड टू सरदार पटेल यूनिवर्सिटी। एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द जीन रेगुलेशन, विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर द नेट एग्जामिनेशन। Probably, you know, if you count, you will find approximately 3 to 4 questions will be generally asked in the C section. So, if we talk about the maintenance of the steady state concentration of a protein, so they are regularly forming the different proteins, and those proteins will be maintained at steady state. Okay, so first of all the gene will transcribe and then translate and finally will form the synthesize the protein. So these proteins are regulated at different levels. Okay, so these gene regulations are mostly regulated metabolically, physiologically or environmentally. Okay, so regulation of gene expression actually is a very broad topic, very broad term, and the regulation of the protein synthesis or regulation of the gene expression is regulated at many or various levels, like transcriptional level, the formation of primary transcript, processing level, transport of the mRNA from the nucleus to the cytoplasm level, translational level. So these are the different levels at which protein synthesis, or we can say the gene regulation, took place. Particularly, we here talking about the gene regulation in prokaryotes. And in prokaryotes particularly, we will focus our study on the transcriptional control. Okay. So what happens in the transcription, first of all, we will discuss. So RNA polymerase at a given promoter will bind, and then along with the RNA, you know, polymerase, the accessory proteins will also be there. It will synthesize the mRNA, and finally the mRNA will be translated into the polypeptide. So these are the, you know, these processes most of the time or many of the times positively regulated or negatively regulated. Positively regulated means, if we talk about the positive regulation, so positive regulation is mostly the activators has been carried out by the activators, and negative regulation has been carried out by the repressors, right? So activation or repression, so these are the things which are accessibility or the thing to take the accessibility of the promoter region. How they these activators or repressors are accessible to their respective promoters, right? So the gene, particularly gene, the different regions are there, the structural gene, then the operator region, promoter regions, or structural gene and as well as the regulatory regions, right? So these RNA polymerases, right, it will bind to the promoter region, then just adjacent to the promoter region the operator region is there, and the operator regions are the region which will mostly assess the binding of the repressor or activators. Okay, so each operon has its specific operator and specific repressor. Actually, now the term comes in the picture is the operon. So first of all we will discuss about the operon. So what is the operon? Okay, so in the prokaryotes, many structural or many genes has been regulated by single regulatory elements, like here three genes are there, gene A, gene B and gene C, right? So these are three different genes encoding different polypeptides and are regulated by single regulatory elements, right? These are the regulatory sequences. And as we talked, this is the operator sequence, this is the promoter region, and this is the activator binding, or you know, the regulatory region. We'll come to the next slide. What are the things? Okay, so first of all, we will discuss how positive as well as the negative regulation takes place, right? So just have a look to this figure. This side is the negative regulation and this side is positive regulation, right? So negative regulation is nothing but if the formation of mRNA and consequently polypeptide has been stopped by some molecule, right? So those molecules are, or those kind of regulations are called negative regulation, okay? And positive regulations are those regulations in which some molecule will make possible the mRNA synthesis, or it will enhance the formation of mRNA, or support the formation of mRNA and consequently protein. So those are called the positive regulation. Like here, so this is gene, and this is the this particular region is the operator region at which some molecule, this pink molecule, has been bound over there, and then it will stop the synthesis of the mRNA. So this is negatively regulated. As the signal molecule, some signal molecule will bind to this particular protein, it will release from the promoter or operator region from here, so it will allow the synthesis of the mRNA, right? So when the operator region has been blocked, so it is not possible to synthesize mRNA. So this is negatively regulated. On the other hand, this one, see B number figure, number B. So when the molecule along with the signal molecule bound to the operator region, so it will block the synthesis of the mRNA. So this is negatively regulated. Once it is released from the operator region, so now it is possible to synthesize mRNA, right? On the other hand, the positive regulation, when the molecule, this green one, this green protein, once bound to the regulatory sequence, it is possible to synthesize mRNA. It synthesizes mRNA, so it is positively regulated, right? If it is released by the action of some signal molecule or like that, so it is not expressed, mRNA is not synthesized, right? So as soon as it is released, so it is not possible to synthesize the mRNA, right? When it is present, it will possible to synthesize mRNA, so it is positively regulated. Again here, the protein along with the signal molecule, this is protein and this is the signal molecule, so if present, so it is possible to synthesize mRNA, so positively regulation, right? So this is called positive and negative regulation. Okay, now we will discuss about, particularly we will discuss about the lac operon, right? So lac operon is the, you know, the operon which was, or the concept of operon actually was discovered by the Francis Jacob and Monod, right, in 1961. First time they elucidate the transcriptionally regulated system which will finally regulate the synthesis of the mRNA as well as the protein, right? So what they found the many more genes are controlled by a single regulatory element, and they gave the term polycistronic. They gave the term polycistronic. So structural gene, maybe more than two genes, are regulated by a single regulatory elements. So they gave the concept of polycistronic structural gene, right? And many more the cluster of genes are there in the prokaryotes, like lac operon, tryptophan operon, arabinose operon, many more operons are there which are regulated by a single promoter, right? Now we'll have a look to the structure of the lac operon, right? So quickly we are going through these topics because we are having many more questions to solve, related questions, right? So lac operon is nothing But the cluster of three genes, LAC Y, LAC Z, LAC Y, and LAC A, right? And these three are called the structural genes. These three are called structural genes, and these structural genes are regulated by a single regulatory element. This is the regulatory element, right? This is the regulatory element. This is the operator region, LAC operator, meant specifically for the LAC operon, and this is the promoter region at which the RNA polymerase will bind. Okay, so this is you know, LAC operon, and this LAC operon, entire LAC operon, has been under the control of a gene which is called LAC I gene, right? And LAC I, this is the LAC I gene, and LAC I gene have its own promoter. See, this is the P LAC I. It will synthesize their own mRNA, own polypeptide, and those polypeptides are called LAC repressor. Okay, this is called LAC repressor, and monomeric form of the LAC repressor has been synthesized, and they are having the domains to form the tetrameric form of the LAC repressor, right? So this is the tetrameric LAC repressor, and tetrameric LAC repressor has the binding site at the operator region. This is the LAC operator region, right? And these three structural gene, LAC Z, it will synthesize three different enzymes: beta galactosidase, Y gene, it will synthesize permease, and LAC A, it will synthesize transacetylase. Okay, now the regulatory gene, I gene, it will synthesize a protein which is called the repressor protein. ZYA, it will synthesize three different proteins, right? And Jacob and Monod, they found these three different genes are playing very, very important role in the lactose metabolism, right? So if we provide lactose to the bacteria, so they will break the lactose into glucose and galactose with the help of these three enzymes. Okay, so now see what is the scenario there. So this is the plasma membrane where the lactose, this is the channel for lactose, it will enter inside the cell with the help of enzyme permease, right? So we have seen here, so LAC Y gene, it will synthesize permease. So permease is the enzyme which will allow the lactose to enter inside the cell. Okay, now so lactose, once lactose enter inside the cell, another enzyme that is called beta galactosidase, see here, so the Z, LAC Z, it will synthesize beta galactosidase. So beta galactosidase will break the lactose into one molecule glucose and galactose respectively, right? Glucose and galactose it will form, and these glucose has been then metabolized, because you know the glucose is the favorite carbon source for the bacterium, right? On the other hand, the beta galactosidase also perform one function which is called conversion of the lactose to its isoform allolactose, right? So this will also having very, very important role, will come to know allolactose, role of the allolactose. Okay, so once the lactose enter, it will break down into the glucose and galactose, right? And some amount of the lactose will convert into the allolactose, right? Now we'll quickly we'll discuss how the LAC operon is switched off and switched on, right? So see, this is the LAC I, as we discussed. So LAC I, it will synthesize LAC repressor monomer, so it will tetramerize themselves to form the active protein. Monomer is inactive, tetramer is active in the sense they are now able to bind with the operator region, right? So they will bind to the operator region, and as we know, the RNA polymerase will bind to the promoter region, right? So RNA polymerase, very, very specific polymerases are there, and those polymerases are having their binding site which are called promoter. So LAC P, sorry, P-lac is the region where the RNA polymerase will bind. This is the region. This is the region where the RNA polymerase will bind, and RNA polymerase will bind to transcribe the leg Z, leg Y, and leg A into the respective mRNA and then polypeptide. But the problem here is that just in front of the promoter, at the operator site, the active tetramer of the lac repressor has been bound. So it is very difficult for the RNA polymerase to cross the operator region to transcribe the leg Z, Y, and A gene. So what happens? No such transcription took place due to the presence of the operator region. So no transcription of the structural gene at all. So this is the case where the gene can be called switched off. Lac operon is switched off, right? Now another case, this one. This is the case where what happens? Lac I again, it synthesizes lac repressor. So lac repressor will again tetramerize as earlier, right? But the thing is that when bacteria having some amount of allolactose, and allolactose is nothing but the isoform of the lactose, once the lactose is inside the cell, it will convert into its isoform, that is called allolactose. And allolactose here acts as inducer, right? Allolactose acts as inducer, and what it do actually, it will bind to the active tetramer and form it inactive. It convert the active tetramer into inactive tetrameric form. Okay, so inactive tetrameric form are now not able to bind. This is the inactive tetramer, right? So now it is not possible to bind with the operator region. Actually, it will change the conformation of the tetramer, right? The actual tetramer, active tetramer, and due to the change in the conformation, it is not possible to bind this with the operator region. And once the operator region is empty, no such tetrameric repressor is there, so it will allow the RNA polymerase, which is already bound at the lac promoter, and consequently it will reach up to the lac Z, lac Y, and lac A, and finally it will synthesize the mRNA. Alright, and once the mRNA has been formed, it will synthesize beta-galactosidase, permease, and transacetylase respectively, right? So this condition is nothing, but this is called switched on, right? So lac operon here is called switched on. So switched off as well as the switched on. So these are the things which will make it possible for the lac operon to switch on or switch off. Now, just we will go through regarding the operator regions. Actually, if you see at a bit more detail, there are three different operators, right? O1, O2, and O3. Okay, O1 is the main operator, and O2 and O3 are the operator which will support the binding of the lac repressor, or which will make the binding stronger, right? So these three operators are there, which O2 and O3 particularly, it will support the lac repressor to bind over there. Okay, now just we had discussion about the allolactose. So allolactose is nothing but the isoform of the lactose, and it acts as the inducer, right? We talked about the inducer. So it will make the tetrameric form of repressor inactive, right? So switch on. So lac operon gets switched on. Okay, so now there is a question: how the very first molecule of the allolactose has been synthesized within the cell? Because once you put your culture in lactose, right, so lactose is not inside cell, lactose is there outside your culture, right? Bacteria, right? So no such lactose is there. So how the permease will synthesize, or how the different enzymes for the lac operon will synthesize to make it possible to enter the lactose inside the cell, because lactose only enters inside the cell only when the permease is present. But permease is not over there because the operon is switched off. Okay, so how it is possible, how it is possible to make the lac operon switched on? Without allolactose it is not possible to switch on. So there is a concept of the Brownian movement always took place, and random collision took place between the RNA polymerase and the different regions of the DNA, right? But the effective collision took place between the promoter of the lac operon and the RNA polymerase which will bind to the lac operon, or made for the lac operon, or the promoter for the lac operon, right? So active very effective collision takes place, right? So once the active collision takes place, it will spend some more time over there, right? And it will try to bypass the operator region, okay? But most of the time it gets unsuccessful, right? But in few cases it will bypass the operator region even though the repressor has been bound over there. So this is something called leaky expression, right? So leaky expression always took place at very minimal level, and once the leaky expression took place, it will synthesize all the three enzymes at the very basal level actually. So the very in the small amount, the permeases are there, permease enzyme is there, all the three enzymes are there. So permease, it make possible to enter the lactose which is there in the medium inside the cell, and once it will enter the cell, the enzyme beta galactosidase is there. So that beta galactosidase enzyme now will break the lactose into glucose and galactose, and it will also convert the lactose into the allolactose, and these allolactose are now function as inducer. So it will induce the lac operon. So it will now molecule which is called RNA polymerase will bind to the promoter region, and it will successfully synthesize many more round of the transcription and translation. So it will make the operon switched on, right? So this is the leaky expression. The case of leaky expression is always there, right? So it will make possible to enter the first molecule of lactose inside the cell. Okay, now the negative regulation, as we talked about the negative regulation in the absence of lactose, the lac operon are repressed in the repressed state. Okay, so the region is very simple. So no lactose, so no allolactose is there. So no allolactose, that means the repressor molecule will bind with the operator region. So no such possibility of the transcription and further translation is there. So the presence of the repressor, it will block the synthesis of the RNA as well as the protein. So it is called negative regulation, and we talked about the operator O1, O2, O3. So these are the things. Now the positive regulation, this is very interesting. Okay, so positive regulation, as we talked about positive regulation is nothing but due to the presence of the regulatory molecule, if some molecule has been synthesized by the gene, like it will first it will transcribe and translate, then it is called positive regulation. Okay, so positive regulation is the case or the factor where the the other factors beside the lactose affect the expression of the lac genes, right? Such as the availability of the glucose, right? So glucose will affect the the lac operon a lot in the regulation, and it will make the lac operon positive regulation. So how we'll discuss this aspect. See, the case is that as we know, the lactose is the the glucose is the most favorite source for the bacteria as a carbon source, right? So once the glucose is there, or glucose is present, so no such, you know, it won't utilize lactose. Even though they are present, they are not able to, they are not utilized actually. So if glucose is there, so if glucose level is high inside the cell, right? So regulatory mechanism is like that. If the glucose level is very, very high, so a protein which is called catabolite repression, right? Catabolite repression. So what it will do, it will restrict the expression of genes required for the catabolism of the lactose, right? When the catabolite repression, right? Catabolite repression is a process, right? Mechanism by which it will make the lacoperon switched off, right? Or arabinose or any operon, right? So what happens actually, the effect of glucose, the effect of glucose is mediated by the CAMP, cyclic AMP. How? We'll discuss first, okay? So if the glucose level is high in the cell, that means the CAMP level is very, very low, right? And vice versa. If the glucose level is low, that means cell will utilize all the glucose and it will form CAMP, right? So CAMP level will high, right? If the glucose is low, CAMP will high. If CAMP will low, glucose will high, right? So this is the thing. So what happens actually, if the CAMP is there and in the cell, if CAMP is there in the high, at high level, so glucose is low, and CAMP as a coactivator acts as coactivator and activator protein, which is called CAMP repressor protein, another protein which is called CAMP repressor protein or CRP, right, which is also called aporepressor, right? Aporepressor. So CAMP and CAMP repressor protein both will bind together to form active CAMP CRP complex, and this active CAMP CRP complex a very important role in the positive regulation of the lacoperon, right? So the last point is that when glucose is absent, CRP CAMP binds to the site near the lac promoter, we'll see in the figure, and stimulate the RNA transcription by 50-fold, right? More than 50-fold it will increase the rate of transcription, right? See, so CAMP CRP is therefore positive regulatory element, right, responsive to the glucose level. So it is regulated always by the level of glucose, right? So where the lac repressor is the negative regulatory element, as we have had discussion about that, right? So both will act in concert, right, in equilibrium. See, this is the case, this is the region of CRP site. CMP CRP will bind here, right, and it will control the entire lac operon, right? So in the presence of, see, this is very important figure actually. So this is the CMP CRP complex, and this CMP CRP complex once will bind at the CRP site, right? So it will make the lac repressor, it will make the lac repressor very loosely bound, and it will go off, and the RNA polymerase, which is already bound at the promoter region, this region, right? So it will then transcribe and translate, transcribe all the three genes, lac, Z, Y, and A, because no such repressor is bound over there, right? So this CMP CRP complex, and CMP CRP complex is only formed at low glucose level. The glucose level is low, right? So CMP CRP complex will form. Once the CMP CRP complex will form, no repressor can bound to the operator region. So it is very easy for the RNA polymerase to cross the operator and transcribe all the three genes, right? On the other hand, if the level of glucose is very, very high, what it does mean? It means that the level of CMP is very, very low, right? So level of CMP is very, very low. So if the level of CMP is very, very low, so it won't be able to form CMP-CRP complex, right? So if CRP and CMP complex will not form, so it is not possible to bind at the CRP site. If CRP site is empty, then the repressor can very easily bound to the operator region, right? So the operator region has been blocked, so it is not possible for RNA polymerase to move over there, so the switch is off, right? So this is the another fine tuning, we can say, the fine tuning at which glucose plays a very important role in the switch on and switch off the lacoperon, right? And this is positive regulation. Why? Because CMP CRP complex, when it is bound to the CRP site, so it will make possible for the all the three genes to transcribe, right? So this is positive regulation. So I hope the positive and negative regulation will be very much clear to you. Okay, now this is very important. So see, whatever earlier we had discussion, those are the very, very basic things, right? But for the NET aspirants, the in the C section, they are mostly asking the mutation related question. So if you mutate this gene, so what will be the scenario? So we are having many more questions, we will have discussion about that. So just we will have a look to the different mutations in the lac operon, right? So two different kind of or many more mutations are there, but lac mutation may be constitutive or may be uninducible, right? What does it mean, constitutive, right? We'll spend some time to understand the constitutive and uninducible. Constitutive means the lac operon always transcribed even in the absence of the inducer, right? If even though the inducer is not present, if the lac operon is on, then it is called housekeeping genes, right? Other term that is called uninducible. Uninducible expression means the genes are not able to express, right? The expression of the lac operon genes can't be induced even though the inducer is present, so it is not possible to induce, right? So constitutive and uninducible. Constitutive, always expression takes place, and uninducible, expression of the lac operon is not possible even though the inducer is there. Another kind of mutation may also be there that can be dominant or recessive, right? Dominant or recessive mutation, right? We'll make it clear during solving the question. So how some mutations are dominant and how some mutations are recessive, right? Then the third thing is the lac mutation may be cis or the trans, right? Lac mutation may be sometimes cis and sometimes trans. Cis and trans, these are the things always also we'll discuss more in the during the question solving session. So cis mutations are those mutations which will be affected by the the sequence or the region which is on the same DNA, right? But trans, it can be the another molecule which will affect the expression. So those mutations are called transmutation. We'll discuss during the question solving session. Another concept regarding the recessive mutation is that recessive mutation can't be complemented or cis acting, right? Recessive mutation cannot be complemented by cis acting molecules, right? So cis acting molecule affects only the expression of the genes on the same DNA, right, where it occurs. Okay, cis, recessive is always cis. Okay, so now to understand the different mutation in the lac operon, monod no, not monoid, Jacob, Jacob, he developed a merozygote, right? Merozygote. Okay. So merozygote are nothing but the partially diploid bacteria which are formed by the Jacob to understand the different kind of mutations in the lac operon. So we will try to understand this concept, right? How he did partially diploid the bacterium, like, you know, he just transferred the exozygote or exogenous lac operon with the help of F prime, right? So a bacterial cell containing an exogenous exozygote donated by the F prime, right? So this is the concept, partial diploid or merozygote is the concept which will help to understand the Jacob to different mutations, right? We will discuss three different cases here, right? The first case is the lac operator in the E. coli with a mutation of the regulatory gene, I gene, right? Means, see, if the case is not the merozygote, right? If we take the simple case in which the regulatory gene, that means I gene, gets mutated, then what happens? Then we'll discuss this figure, right? What happens when the I gene gets mutated? That means it won't able to synthesize the repressor. Understood? Okay. So if it is not able to synthesize the repressor, then the operator is always free. Okay. All right. If operator is free, then promoter will, or the RNA polymerase which is over the promoter, will very smoothly transcribe the Z, Y and A gene, right? Always, whether the inducer is present or not, it won't mind, they won't mind, right? RNA polymerase always will synthesize mRNA of the Z, Y and A gene. So the operon is constitutively expressed. Understood? Clear? Now, Jacob and Monod, what he did, what he tried to understand, he tried to understand the case, mutation case of the regulatory gene. So he made the merozygote, right? Means the they transferred a molecule, entire gene, actually entire operon, actually, with the help of a prime, into a bacterium which is having defective regulatory gene, right? Defective regulatory gene, right? Actually the bacterium is having defective regulatory gene, I gene, right? But the gene which is transferred into the bacterial cell, which will make the bacterial cell partial diploid, have I plus gene, right? So this is the case. Okay, this one, I plus, right? So this is the DNA which is introduced inside the bacterium. This is the original lac operon in which I gene is mutated, right? I gene is mutated. So what happens, what will be the scenario in the merozygote, in the partial diploid condition? So this won't be able to, this I gene, it won't be able to synthesize the repressor, so this is negative, that's why. But the gene or lac operon, which is lac operon along with the regulatory element which is introduced in the cell, are able to synthesize the repressor molecule because they are I plus. Okay, so it will tetramerize themselves, right? It will become active, And once it is active, then it can very easily bind to the operator which is there on the bacterial chromosome or lac operon of the bacterial chromosome, as well as the operon which is transferred into the bacterial cell, right? Means the lac operon which is introduced into the bacterial cell. So both the gene, the lac operons, the gene for the lac operon which was originally on the bacterial chromosome, and the gene which are introduced into the bacterial cell, both operon gets repressed. All right? Because inducer is not here, inducer is not there. In the absence of inducer, so it will block the synthesis of the mRNA of Z, Y and A. Both the E. coli chromosome or lac operon, which is situated on the E. coli chromosome, as well as the lac operon which are introduced. So what happens if the regulatory gene gets mutated, right? So it will make the operon repressed, right? Repressed. This is the first case. Second case is that this is again to understand the mutation, right? So lac operon in the E. coli with a mutation in the operator region. Okay, so first we will try to understand in the cell, means without partial diploid, means without mirozygote, means normal cell. In the normal cell where the E. coli chromosome is there and we mutated the operator region, right? Operator region we mutated this region, right? Operator region, we mutated operator region, this region, right? So I plus is there, right? This is normal wild type, so it will synthesize repressor. So this is the repressor. Repressor will tetramerize, right? And once it is tetramerized, now it will become active, and once it is active, it will try to bind with the operator region. But operator here is mutated, right? So the active site which are responsible for binding of this tetramer to the operator region is now not able to bind with the operator region, right? So what happens? The cell will always, or the lac operon gene in the cell is always in the constitutively expressed state. All right, constitutively expressed state, right? Now we try to understand when they made the mirozygote, right? Mirozygote means partial diploid. So in the partial diploid case, they introduced this DNA, or not DNA actually, this entire set of lac operon inside the cell, right? In which normal operator is there, no mutation. Mutation is there in the wild type, right? Wild type mutated this DNA, the DNA which is there on the E. coli chromosome or lac operon of the E. coli chromosome. So now what happens? Both the regulatory gene, I plus gene, right, will synthesize the repressor, right? These are the repressor. So these repressor will tetramerize, monomer will tetramerize, tetramerize, and these tetrameric active form is not able to bind with the wild type lac operator because that operator is mutated, right? But they are very much able to bind with the operator of the lac operon which is introduced inside the bacterial cell. So what happens? The gene or lac operon genes are constitutively expressed in the wild type, but it is repressed in the gene which is introduced in the mirozygote, right? So F prime exerts, see the sentence, the F prime exerts no control over the chromosomal mutant. Okay, in the earlier case they have control, right? They controlled, right? both operons are repressed in the earlier case, case 1, but in case 2, a prime exerts, means the exogenous lac operon gene exerts no control over the chromosomal mutation of the operator region, right, OC, which exerts a cis dominant effect. See, we talked about cis and trans. So the first case, this case, what happens? The tetramer or the repressor, which is synthesized by the DNA, which is from the exogenous source, right? This is the gene, this is the operon or lac operon, which was introduced, and it will synthesize the tetramer, and those tetramer have effect on the expression. All right. So this is called transacting. All right. But here, see the case. Even though this is synthesizing, right? Synthesizing repressor, but operator is mutated here. Operator in the wild type mutated. So even though the tetramers are there, but they are not able to bind with the operator region, right? What does it mean? So mirozygote DNA doesn't have any contribution once you mutate the operator region. All right, if you mutate the operator, then it won't be controlled by the mirozygote or the DNA which is introduced inside the, or the lac operon which was introduced inside the cell. So this is, means operator is regulated by the cis acting element, right? So this should be clear to you. Actually, in the NET exam, they are very much or very frequently they are asking, right? So the operator mutation is cis dominant, right? That means the exogenous DNA doesn't have any significant effect once you mutate the operator region. So this is the second case. Third case is again very interesting. See, a lac operon in the E. coli, lac operon in the E. coli with mutant regulatory gene I-D. See, here the mutation is there in the regulatory gene. See, first case was also there mutation in the regulatory gene minus I, right? But here the case is different actually. Minus ID means dominant negative, right? That was simple, mutation in the regulatory gene, but here the mutation is different. So mutation occur in the DNA binding site of the polypeptide. Getting the point? See, there in the first case, mutation was there in the I gene, and they are not able to synthesize the repressor protein, right? But here the case is different. The mutation is there in such a way so that it can synthesize repressor protein, but they are not able to synthesize the DNA binding domain in the repressor, which was synthesized by the I minus D to bind to the operator region. All right. So what happens? Minus ID. So again, if the case without mirozygote in the wild type we are taking. So minus ID mutation, it will form the polypeptide, means repressor it will form, right? But those repressors are not able to bind with the operator. Why? Because the DNA binding domain of the repressor protein gets mutated, right? Means that pocket has not been formed in that protein, right? Or repressor protein, so that it can bind to the operator. Okay, understood? So what happens? The gene is always in the constitutive expression state. Clear? Okay, so gene is always there in the constitutive expression. Now we made the meiozygote, right? Once we made the meiozygote, so meiozygote normal, you know, I plus is there, right? So this is I plus. So I plus, it will synthesize normal repressor, right? Normal repressor they synthesize. So normal repressor, and this is mutated repressor, right? Repressor is there, but mutated means they are not able to bind with the, or even tetramer, they are not able to bind with the operator region, right? So what happens, both proteins are there, so tetramer of the repressor will formed randomly, some, you know, normal monomer and some mutated monomers, like this is mutated, this is white one is the normal, right? So overall the conformation of this tetramer is not very much suitable for binding with the operator region, right? Even the operator of the, you know, the operon which was introduced, and the operon which was originally there in the E. coli. So this tetramer are not able to bind with the operators of these lac operon. So operator is free. Now if operator is free, then we know the RNA polymerase can move smoothly. They can synthesize RNA, mRNA from the Z, Y and A, right? So the genes are there in the constitutive state. So constitutive expression of both wild type as well as the DNA which was introduced in the cell, right? So this is the case. Okay, now see, this is very important. This is the table, very important table, and this table is just for the better understanding of the different mutation, right? Better understanding for the mutation. See, here it is genotype, here it is genotype, this is without inducer, with inducer, and phenotype. Try to understand this table, you know, because you know, in the NET most of the question they are asking from, you know, this concept actually. Okay, this is table just for making the concept. See what happens, this is the actual genotype, I plus, O plus and Z plus, means everything is normal, right? Wild type. So without, no such inducer is there, without inducer means they are having inducer, this is plus, right? So with inducer, inducer means allolactose is there, or IPTG is also there, right? IPTG, right? So this inducer will bind with the repressor, right, and make the operon inducible, right? So they gets induced or expressed. Okay, second case, I minus, see the case, I minus, okay, O plus in Z plus. I minus means what? I minus means they are not able to synthesize the regulatory protein, right? So if they are not able to synthesize, even in the presence of the inducer, right, even in the presence of inducer, okay, without inducer or with inducer, the genes are constitutively expressed, right? Because no such inducer is there, okay, sorry, repressor is there, I'm sorry, no such repressor is there, so genes are constitutively expressed, all right? Now the case of meiozygote, just see, this is the original, means the bacterial chromosome containing I minus, O plus and Z plus, okay? This is the lac operon which was introduced in the meiozygote, right? So what happens, the I minus, it is not able to form the repressor, but I plus, it is able to form the repressor, right? And both the repressor from the I plus, from the meiozygote, okay, the DNA which was introduced from outside, are able to synthesize the repressor. So in the presence of inducer, right, in the presence of inducer, they are inducible, right? They are not constitutively expressed, okay? So because, you know, repressor is there, so if the inducer is there, then only it can be induced, right? Means no such constitutive. Okay, third case, I plus, fourth case, okay, this is the, you know, wild type I plus O plus Z plus, and this is the mirozygote I minus, right? Same case, same third and fourth are same case, only the difference is that the DNA or the operon, lac operon, which was introduced in the mirozygote are I minus, right? So this is again inducible in the presence of the inducer. Okay, third case I plus OC. See, OC means mutated, right? Operator gets mutated again. You can remember the case, even in the presence or absence of the inducer, the gene gets constitutively expressed. Why? Because operator is mutated, so operator, it is not able to not allow the binding of the repressor, even though repressor is synthesized, right? Repressor is synthesized, but it is not able to bind with the operator. So operator is free, so RNA polymerase can move very smoothly, so it can synthesize all the three Z, Y and A mRNA, right? Then next case is I plus OC and Z plus, right? And this is the DNA which is introduced. Z minus, see, this is the Z minus, means the structural gene gets mutated in the mirozygote. Okay, but the structural gene which is there in the wild type is normal, right? So repressor is synthesized from both the DNA. Repressor has been synthesized, but it cannot bind with the mutated operator of the wild type, right? So the wild type gene is silenced, right? Constitutively expressed, because operator is mutated, so no such repressor can bind to the operator region. But in the lac operon introduced into the mirozygote, they are having normal operator O plus, right? They allow the binding of the repressor over there, right? And the RNA polymerase can smoothly move over there, right? RNA polymerase can move smoothly over there. So even in the presence of the inducer or in the absence of the inducer, they are constitutively expressed. All right. Last case, the I plus OC, again the wild type is mutated, right? Z plus. And here I minus, see, this is I minus. I minus means the repressor is not synthesized. Okay, repressor of the gene which was the lac operon which was introduced are not able to synthesize the repressor, but the wild type is able to synthesize the repressor, right? So it will synthesize the repressor, it can bind very easily to the operator region here, but it is Z negative, so no such overall effect. So in the with inducer or without inducer, the genes are constitutively expressed. Okay, because operator is blocked. See, try to understand, operator is blocked here in the normal case, right? But in the in the DNA which was introduced in the diploid cell, Z minus means here in this case, even though the operator is free, right, to bind with the repressor, but the structural gene gets mutated, right? So no such expression takes place in the operon which was introduced outside, right? But the only gene or only operon which is already there in the wild type, right, are Z plus. And another thing is that it won't bind with the, or repressor won't bind with the OC, right, operator, because operator is mutated. So the wild type gets expressed their mRNA as well as the protein every time, so it is constitutive, right? So this one is constitutive as well as this one is constitutive. So try to understand here, Z minus means they are not able to synthesize mRNA. A structural gene gets mutated, okay? So RNA polymerase won't move smoothly over there, even though operator is free, right? So this is the thing, this is very important, and one should understand very, very, you know, carefully to this table. Okay, now we will discuss the questions which normally they are asking in the NET examination, right? So we will discuss around 30 questions, 30 or 31 questions we are having. We will discuss those questions and try to answer on the basis of our concept which we develop in this session, right? So we'll come to questions one by one. See, the first question: the genes whose products are constantly needed for the cellular activity are called. This is very simple question, okay? And they are called housekeeping genes, all right? Because gene products which are constantly needed means always expressed, constitutive expression, right? So housekeeping genes are, that is called housekeeping gene, all right? This is a very simple question actually. So another question, see, the product of constitutive gene may be the P involved in catabolic pathway, Q involved in anabolic pathway, R continuously synthesized, S involved in the synthesis of structural element in the cell. See, we will discuss one by one choice how we can eliminate and we can find the correct answer. So P and Q, right? So first is a P and Q. So the product of the constitutive gene may be, P is involved in the catabolic pathway, okay, all right, and Q is the involved in the anabolic pathway. This is also you know, correct. Then continuously synthesized, okay, this is also correct. So A number choice is not correct. Then B is also not correct, because you know, Q is not there in the B. C, choice number C, P and S. S is involved in the synthesis of a structural element in the cell. This is also correct actually. So choice number D, P, Q, R and S, all of them are correct. All right. This is also a very simple question. Now, which of the following is not an example of allosteric regulation? This is important, right? Allosteric. This is new term actually, new word. See, allosteric, what is allosteric? First of all, I'll briefly explain here. Allosteric sites are those sites, or you know, allosteric sites are sites which are the site or other site, you know, the main enzyme active site is different, and allosteric sites are different where the molecule can bind and alter the function of the enzyme, right? So allosteric, first of all, we should understand the allosteric, okay? So allosteric sites are those sites which are apart from the enzyme regulatory sites, right? So we'll read one by one choice. So regulation of phosphofructokinase activity by fructose 2,6 bisphosphate, okay, all right, okay, this is not there in the lycopyrrole, hold on. Choice number B is inactivation of nitrogenase by ADP ribosylation, okay, this is also not there in the lycopyrrole, so we again hold on this choice. C number, regulation of the lacoperon by allolactose in E. coli. See, what is this choice actually? Regulation of the lacoperon by allolactose in E. coli. See, allolactose, what it does actually? It will bind to the active site, which will bind to the active site of the repressor, and it will make it unable to bind with the operator region, right? So it will change the you know, active site of the, or active site which will able responsible for binding the lac repressor with the operator region, right? Okay, we'll come to that point. Last one is the catabolite repression by CAP in E. coli. No. Okay, so CAP, they are having CRP binding site, right? So that is not allosteric. So regulation of the lack of a question is, which of the following is not an example of allosteric regulation, right? Allosteric, not an example, right? So directly it will alter the binding site of the original binding site or enzyme's original binding site to the DNA. So regulation of the lac operon by the allolactose in E. coli will be the correct answer, because it will change the active site of the regulatory protein, right, repressor, to bind with the operator region. Okay, see, if we talk about the choice number A, so just have a look to this slide. Okay, so what this slide explains actually, allosteric activity or allosteric control of the phosphofructokinase choice number one activity. So phosphofructokinase PFK1 and PFK2, right, two different kind of phosphofructokinases are there. So this enzyme is bifunctional actually. If the allosterically it will change, right, so it will function as PFK2. PFK1 will change to work as PFK2, right? Okay, so first choice is the very good example of allosteric regulation. Okay, B number is the inactivation of the nitrogenase by ADP ribosylation. Okay, just a minute, actually I was wrong. C number choice is not correct actually. The B number choice, inactivation of the nitrogenase by ADP ribosylation. Actually, this is the correct answer. Inactivation of the nitrogenase enzyme, which will be inactivated by the ADP ribosylation. Okay. Regulation of the lac operon by the allolactose in the E. coli is not an example of allosteric actually, right? So B number, see, the explanation of the B is also there. This one, the regulation of the nitrogen fixation. So this is the enzyme nitrogenase enzyme is there. So nitrogenase enzyme, it will use ATP and it will convert ADP. This is the ADP, right? And then it will produce ADP by using the ATP, and this ADP will allosterically, or it will bind at the nitrogenase allosteric site. Okay, it will bind to the nitrogenase at their allosteric site. So this is the answer actually. Inactivation of the nitrogenase by ADP ribosylation. Okay, so which of the following is not an example of the allosteric regulation? Okay, fourth question. In a bacteria, the genes that code for the enzyme of a metabolic pathway are usually arranged constitutively to form a functional unit called the first choice, an induction system. Okay, what is question? Question is the bacteria, the genes that code for the enzyme of a metabolic pathway are usually arranged consecutively from the to form a functional unit. Okay, are called operon. Okay, this is a very simple question actually. So this is operon, concept given by the Jacob and Monod. Okay, then next question. A series of genes that are transcriptionally regulated in trans, see, pick up the point, trans regulation. Question is talking about the trans regulation, right, by DNA binding protein are called a transcriptor. This is the trans what we had discussion about the trans. So trans are the factors which are synthesized by the other fragment or other other part of the gene which are not situated on the same chromosome, right? So transcription factors. Okay, transcriptors. So this is not a correct choice. So repressor, right? So repressor, we have seen repressor are always bind to the same promoter, right, or different promoter also, right? And then promoter RNA polymerase will bind to the promoter, right? And then this is operon. Okay, a series of genes that are transcriptionally regulated in trans by DNA binding protein are called, this is possible in operon actually. This is a simple question. This is actually possible in the operon, right? We have seen. Okay. Next question. So, operons, just they are asking about the definition. Okay. Not definition actually, are approximately uniform in size. This is not correct. Not uniform in size. Like lac operon, it contains 3 gene. Tryptophan operon, it contains 5 different genes. So length will different actually, not uniform. So do not bind proteins. No, of course it bind protein. Different proteins will bind over there, right? Are found in some eukaryotic genes. Very few eukaryotic genes. They are having operons actually. They arranged as an operon, right? So this might be correct answer. We'll first of all go through the D choice. So are shorter and smaller in lower eukaryotes than higher? No, this is not the case. Okay, so this is not the case. Shorter or higher? No, this is not any such report is there. So are found in some eukaryotes also. So operons are also found in the eukaryotes. This is also a simple question actually. Now, the following are the basic properties of the prokaryotic operon. The operon P usually consists of multiple genes that are organized between a promoter and a terminator site. Okay, so this is correct. Q is usually under autogenous transcriptional control. No, this is not correct, because we had discussion, it is usually under, you know, not autogenous control, right? Operon may be transacting also, so this is not autogenous control. And R is member genes are coordinately regulated. Yeah, this is correct. Coordinately regulated, they are very coordinately regulated or orchestrated manner they are regulated actually, right? Then S, so P is correct, then R is also correct. Okay, then S exclusively contains genes that encode proteins involved in the stress tolerance. Exclusively, not exclusively. That's why this is wrong choice actually. Exclusively contains gene that encode protein. No, not exclusively stress condition tolerance. Okay. They may present for the, without stress tolerance also, right? Operons are also there. So P and R are the correct choice. So B number is the correct choice, P and R. Okay. I hope you understand the things. Okay. Now, which of the following statement about the repressor of the lactose operon of E. coli are true? Okay. P choice. It is the gene product of the regulatory gene. Of course, this is correct. We have seen. It binds to the operator region of lac operon. Okay, this is also true. Okay, repressor. Statement question is about the repressor, right? About the repressor, right? Regulatory genes are synthesized, then it will bind to the operator. This is correct. It blocks the transcription of a structural gene. Of course, this is also correct. Okay. It combines with allolactose. Of course, allolactose. It can bind, and combination will not bind to the operator. Of course, this is also correct. Okay. Once the allolactose will bind, then it is not possible to bind with the operator. So all the PQRS are correct. So D choice is correct answer, most correct answer. Yeah, D number. Now, choose the incorrect pair. So DNA sequence, okay, pair. Okay, so DNA sequence to which the RNA polymerase bind, promoter site. Okay, yes, it can bind to the promoter site. This is correct. Then the DNA sequence to which sigma factor binds, this is enhanced. No, sigma factor actually, this is the case which is there in the, you know, recognition of the promoter sigma factor. It function as the function to scan the promoter, so it won't bind with the enhancer sequence. So this is most probably, this is the wrong answer. Okay, but C number, the DNA sequence that codes for a protein, a structural gene, of course is correct. So DNA sequence to which repressor bind, repressor means operator site. Okay, this is also correct. Okay, so C and D is also correct. So B number is the wrong answer. Okay, so this is the incorrect pair. Okay, see, just I wanted to give one suggestion that always you go through all the choice, right? Not like that just you read the A choice and you find out, okay, this is the correct, so just you on no. Okay, try to make the habit to read all the four options in the NET examination, right? Okay, so the correct answer here is the B. Okay, now which of the following gene is not transcribed from the promoter of beta galactosidase? Okay, so beta galacto, which of the following gene is not transcribed? Okay, so Z, Y, A, we have seen, right? These are the structural gene. Okay, Z, Y and A, which of the following not transcribed from the promoter of the B? So LAC I is the, you know, separate gene. Okay, so they are having separate promoter. Okay, we had discussion about that, just you go back. See, they are having separate promoter. We come to the structure, you see. So here, this is a separate promoter. They are having separate promoter. Okay, like I, they are having separate promoter. So that is the LAC I. Answer is the LAC I. Okay, so which of the following compound is a gratuitous inducer of the beta galactosidase in E. coli? Okay, so IPTG, we had discussion about allolactose, right? So allolactose is a molecule which is the isoform of the lactose, but isoform of the lactose. But what happens, the allolactose has been utilized, okay, once it is formed, right? Allolactose is nothing but the it will form in the equilibrium of the lactose. Once the concentration of lactose has been low, so allolactose will convert back into the lactose. So during the experiment or during the growth and the maintenance of the bacteria, so all the allolactose, or not all but almost, the allolactose has been utilized, right? But the IPTG, isopropylthiogalactoside, is the synthetic chemical, right, which is not utilized in the metabolism, but it functions very similar to the allolactose. So it is the continuous inducer, so it is called gratuitous inducer of the beta galactosidase of the E. coli, right? So this is the inducer, IPTG. C number is the, so see, just you go through the literature here, it is written IPTG C, not this one. So allolactose is the inducer and it may utilize, but the IPTG is the inducer, which is not supposed to, or which is not utilized during the metabolism of the different pathway. So IPTG is the inducer which normally researchers are using for the research purpose, right? Because it is not utilizable. Okay, and they also don't have any side effect on the growth and maintenance of the E. coli. So isopropyl thiogalactoside is the correct answer, right? Gratuitous inducer. Okay, introduction of the beta galacto sidage activity by IPTG is the result of, okay, induction of the beta galactosidase activity by IPTG is the result of, so stimulation of the lac repressor function, no, it won't stimulate, actually it will block the function of the repressor to bind with the operator. IPTG binds to lac operon and inducing transcription. No, it inhibits the transcription. IPTG binds to the the lac repressor, and consequently it is not able to bind with the operator region, right? So operon and inducing transcription, IPTG binds to the lac operon, not lac operon, actually this is the wrong word used, okay? So this is not the correct choice. It won't bind with the lac operon, it bind with the lac repressor, okay? IPTG binding to the lac I gene product, yeah, this is the correct answer. Lac I gene product, that means repressor, and inhibiting the activity, inhibiting its activity, of course, okay? So it gets it is now not able to bind with the operator region. And last choice also, inhibition of the beta galactosidase, degradation, it won't degrade actually. So C number is the correct, so it will bind with the lac I gene product, that is repressor, and finally it will inhibiting its activity, okay. 13 number question, if there is a deletion mutation in the operator, okay, now this is a mutation question, so be careful. Mutation in the operator of the lac operon, right? Operator of the lac operon, where mutation took place, operator, the expression of the lac structural gene will be, now you can answer very well, operator region. That means even though the repressor is there, right, with or without inducer, right, it is not able to bind with the operator, right, because operator is mutated, okay, mutation is there at the operator. So even in the absence of the inducer, it won't bind with the, or tetramer of the repressor is not able to bind with the operator, right? So gene gets constitutively expressed, or operon gets constitutively expressed, right? Okay, now next question, 14 number, the lac operon is negatively regulated by repressor, negatively regulated by repressor, of course we had discussion about the negative and positive regulation. So repressor, it binds to the operator and it will discontinue, or it will block the synthesis of the mRNA and protein. So this is negatively regulated, of course this is correct. Encoded by lac I gene, of course lac I gene, a mutation in the lac I that prevents the binding of lactose will result in. So where mutation taking place? Mutation took place at the lac I gene, right? So a mutation in lac I gene, lac I, prevents the binding of lactose will result in, okay, the first choice. So mutation is there in the lac I gene, right? So the constitutive phenotype that will be recessive, okay? Now see, one thing is very clear that if mutation took place in the lac I gene, right, lac I gene, so no such repressor has been formed, okay, or if repressor has also been formed, it won't bind with the operator, as we have seen in the lac minus ID, right? So the constitutive expression takes place, no problem, no doubt, without any doubt the constitutive expression took place, but the phenotype that will be recessive is not correct. How? See, recessive is always cis acting, right? Recessive, as we had discussion, right? Recessive is always cis acting. See, this is the slide. Recessive is always cis acting. See, cis dominant, okay? Cis is always dominant, okay? Cis is always dominant on the same operon, right? Control elements should be same, should be at the same operon, right? This one. So phenotype that will be recessive, okay? So this is not correct. So phenotype is not recessive. So constitutive phenotype that will be recessive, no, that will not be recessive, okay? B number, uninducible phenotype that will be dominant, okay? See, Here the lac mutation. So lac I gene is mutated, right? So if the lac I gene is mutated, then the protein is not a mutation in the lac I that prevents the binding of lactose. See, prevents the binding of lactose. So what does it mean? It means they are forming repressor. They are forming repressor, right? They are forming repressor, but those repressors are not able to bind with the operator region, okay? Due to the minus ID mutation. They are talking about minus ID mutation, okay? So, if minus ID mutation is there, then uninducible phenotype that will be dominant. So, an uninducible phenotype will be there. Uninducible phenotype means they are not able to bind with the operator region, right? So there is no such case of induction, right? So that particular operon is always in the expressed state, okay? All right. And these are the dominant phenotype, because if you provide any mirozygote, or if you think the experiment in the mirozygote, so mirozygotic lac I, right, they can prevent the expression of the lac operon, right? C number choice, and constitutive phenotype that will be dominant. Constitutive phenotype that will be dominant, okay. So constitutive phenotype, if we are not taking the case of mirozygote, right, in the wild type, if lac I prevents the binding of lactose will result in, okay. So constitutive phenotype that will be dominant, no, okay. Then D number, the uninducible phenotype that will be recessive, no. See, now what this question is saying, this is a good question actually. The question is that if you mutate the lac I gene, and mutation is there in such a way that the lactose, or we can say allolactose here, actually if they kept allolactose instead of lactose, then question will be more clear actually. So if the lactose or allolactose, we can say isoform, is not able to bind with the repressor, so this is the question. Mutation is there in such a way so that allolactose is not able to bind with the repressor, okay. So if not able to bind with the repressor, so tetramer will become active, so it will bind to the operator, right? So it will block the synthesis, right? So constitutive expression, first choice is wrong answer, no constitutive expression, okay. Second, uninducible, right, uninducible phenotype that will be dominant. See, uninducible phenotype means what? Because they should be induced, right, means they mutated in such a way so that allolactose is not able to bind, so without induction it is not possible to express. So that's why B number choice, an uninducible phenotype, so they will show uninducible phenotype because allolactose is not able to bind with the tetrameric repressor, right? So that will be, and this is dominant. Why? Because if you put mirozygote, if you keep the mirozygotic form, then in the mirozygote the repressor which is synthesized normal will bind to the allolactose and it can block the synthesis, right? So this is dominant, this is trans type, okay. So trans, that means this is dominant, okay. So B number is the correct answer. Why C is not correct? C is constitutive phenotype, right? Constitutive phenotype, no, constitution not takes place here, constitutive not expression, because allolactose is not able to bind with the this molecule, your tetrameric form of the repressor, so no constitutive. So uninducible phenotype, that will be recessive. D number choice is wrong because they mentioned recessive. So trans is not recessive, trans is always dominant, right? So B number, this is a very good question actually. Uninducible phenotype, that will be dominant. So this is the correct answer. I hope you understand the thing. Okay, this is a very good question. Now, 15 number question. Bacteria utilize glucose first, of course, this is correct, even if other sugars are present, of course, though a mechanism called, right? So this mechanism is called catabolite repression actually, right? We have seen actually, so glucose, positive regulation, right? Positive regulation, it was the case of positive regulation, glucose, right? Just have a look to the slide. This one, okay? So glucose, they are talking about glucose, positive regulation, right? So this is the glucose, and see here, catabolite repression, right? This one, this catabolite repression. So positive regulation in the presence of glucose is an example of catabolite repression, okay? So answer is catabolite repression, okay? So catabolite repression, glucose first. So they are blocking, actually they are blocking the utilization of other source of sugar by catabolite repression. This is the question actually. Okay, another question. Catabolite activator protein CAP, okay, age. So CAP will bind to the CAMP, right? We have seen in the theoretical part. So CAMP and CRP complex will bind to the region and it will make the lacoperon positively regulated. So CAMP is the CAMP and catabolite activator protein. So catabolite activator protein is inducer actually. See, just you go to the theoretical slide, you will find. See here, CAMP, the CAMP is a co-activator, right? CAMP is co-activator, but CRP only activate when the CAMP is bound to that, right? So CRP is apo-inducer, right? This is apo-inducer, right? And CAMP is co-activator, right? So the question was, what is CRP? So CRP is co-inducer, sorry, apo-inducer, I'm sorry. CRP is apo inducer, okay? This is a direct question actually. So CRP is apo inducer, so this is the correct answer, right? Apo inducer. Now 17 number, CAMP regulates the lac operon by, okay, we should read the choice. So binding of operator to turn on transcription, no. Binding to operator, no, it won't bind with the operator, it will bind with the CRP. So this is wrong. So this is the wrong choice, okay, wrong answer. Binding to lac repressor to prevent the transcription, no, this is not correct. Combining with the catabolite activator protein CAP, CAP, okay, to form the complex that will turn on transcription, yes, after the binding near the promoter, yeah, near the promoter, it will bind. CMP, CRP site is very, very near to the promoter, that we have seen in the theoretical portions, right? So C is the correct answer, okay? Now, full expression of lac repressor, lac operon requires, full expression of lac operon requires, okay, full expression, okay, this is good question, and because you know they set the choice in the very good manner. This is very clever question actually. This is good question as well as clever question. Why? See here, the full expression means the lac operon will express to their highest, you know, level. When they will achieve, first thing, they should have lactose,
right? They should have lactose, otherwise why the lactoferrin will express? They will switch off otherwise, right? So lactose will be there. So first and foremost thing is the lactose should be there, right? But lactose directly, they are not taking part in the activation of the repressor into the active repressor into the inactive repressor. So instead of lactose, we should mention allolactose. Clear? Do you get the thing? Full expression only when the repressor will be inactivated. And when repressor will be inactivated? When the allolactose is there in the sufficient quantity, right? Sufficient quantity. So allolactose is the first thing. Another thing, so D number choice is the allolactose, but D is the not correct answer, because lactoferrin is not dependent only on the lactose and allolactose concentration. They also regulated by the glucose level. All right, we have seen, actually we have discussed in the theoretical portion. So they should also regulate at the basis of the CAMP, right? Glucose level in the CAMP. So if the CAMP level is very, very high, okay, very, very high, means glucose level is very, very low, right? Then only the expression of the lactoferrin will be at the top, right? So the choice number B, that seems very, very suitable choice. Allolactose should be very, very high, as well as the CAMP, right? CAMP will be at very, very high level, means the glucose will be at very, very low level. So B number is the correct answer. Lactose at the very high level and CAMP will be at very high level. So that positive regulation and negative regulation both will take place. Actually positive regulation, this is positive regulation actually. Case of positive regulation, CAMP by the positive regulation. So allolactose and CAMP is the correct answer. This is very, clever question, good question as well as the clever question. So we should always keep the, things in mind. That not the D choice is correct, B choice is correct, because CMP plays a very important role. Now, 19 number. A loss of function mutation in the gene that encodes the catabolite activator protein, okay? Loss of function, right? Loss of function. Mutation is there in the loss of function. In the gene that encodes CAP, right? Of E. coli would have what effect on the expression of lactoferrin? Okay, so what is the effect? Okay, if CAP is not forming, so we should read the choice. Expression would be very high in the presence of lactose. Okay, all right, and off in the absence, regardless of presence or absence of the glucose. Okay, loss of function mutation in the gene that encodes the catabolite activator protein CAP in the E. coli would have what effect on the expression of lactoferrin? Expression would be very high in the presence of lactose, this is correct. Okay, and off in its absence, okay, this is also correct. Off in the absence of lactose, right? And in its absence, regardless of the presence or absence of glucose, right? No. If the glucose is present, then of course lactoferrin will be switched off. Okay, so this is not independent of the lactose, right? Sorry, glucose. If glucose is there, then lactoferrin should be off, switched off, right? So this is not correct answer. B number, expression would be low in the presence of lactose and off in its absence. Okay, regardless of the presence or absence of lactose. Okay, expression would be low in the presence of lactose. Okay, might be. If just started, then this is correct. Presence of lactose and off in the absence, of course lactoferrin will off in the absence of lactose, of course this is correct. Regardless of the presence or absence of regardless
in the presence or absence of lactose. Regardless, okay, we'll go to the next choice, then we can decide. Expression would be low in the presence of glucose, okay, and very high in the in its absence, okay, regardless of the absence or presence of lactose. Okay, expression would be low in the presence of glucose. This is correct, somewhat this is correct, and very high in its absence. Okay, regardless of the presence or absence. No, this is in presence of lactose, this is correct, but in the absence of lactose, how come lycopyrone will be switched on? So this is wrong answer. Actually, this is particularly wrong answer. One by one we are making wrong, so this is also wrong. Okay, B we haven't decided yet. D number, expression would be off in the presence of glucose. Yes, it may be possible, it may be, or it is possible actually, in the presence of glucose, and low in its absence regardless of the presence of the if the lactose is present, then lycopyrone is switched on. So regardless presence or absence, this is also wrong. Regardless of the presence or the absence of, no, if lactose is there, then it is switched on, right? So 1, 2, and 3, sorry, A, C, and D is wrong answer, that we can say. Now again we go through the B option. Expression would be low in the presence of lactose. Okay, low in the presence of lactose, initial condition of the activation, just started lycopyrone, and off in the absence, this is also correct. If lactose is not there, so operon will be switched off, right? Now regardless of the presence or absence of the lactose, regardless of the presence or absence of lactose. This is a bit confusing actually, but regardless of presence or absence of lactose, where lactose is given here also and here also. So up to here this is very correct, but last, regardless of the presence or absence of the lactose, so if the lactose is there, so certainly it is switched on. Okay, might be this is the case, it depends on the how much allolactose is present or other things, but these three choices are wrong. So another thing which is very important in the CSIR exam is making the strategy. Okay, so we should set the strategy. Once we set the strategy, we can answer some questions which are not 100% we are knowing. We can answer it on the basis of elimination process, like this question. This is very good example of elimination process. So here, see, we eliminated three choices very well, okay, and the second choice, B number choice, bit B number choice, the regardless of the presence or absence of the lactose is bit not suitable here actually, but any one choice is correct. Okay, so B number choice is the most suitable answer. If not correct, this is very suitable answer, B choice. So we can certainly answer the B. Okay, so B number is the correct answer. So this is the knowledge as well as the strategy based question. So you make the strategy, you set your strategy, and you answer the question. Okay, so B number is the correct answer. 20 number, which of the following sequence of events occur when E. coli are released from catabolite repression by transfer to low glucose containing medium? Okay, again the positive regulation, this is question from the positive regulation. Which of the following sequence of event they are asking? Okay, so one by one we'll go through. CAMP level rises, of course, glucose level is low, CAMP level will high. CAMP bind to the CAP cap, of course, they will bind CAP. Then CAMP, CAP cap complex bind to the site of the DNA, of course, just behind the promoter, they will bind and activate the... Okay, this is the correct answer, but we should go through all the choices actually. This is correct. Because sometime what happens, in the D choice, they will write all of the above. Here, this is not the case, but we should go through this because they are not asking the correct answer. If you read the instructions, they are... telling that you should choose the most appropriate answer. Okay, so maybe most appropriate answer will be different. The B number choice, CAMP level rigid, of course, CAMP binds to the cap. Okay, this is also correct. CAMP cap complexes bind to the site of DNA and represses the transcription. This is wrong word. Okay, so this is incorrect. Okay, this is incorrect. C number, the CAMP level rigid. Okay, correct. CAMP binds to cap. Okay, this is also correct. CAMP cap complex is removed from the site. No, see, this is wrong. Okay, so this is also wrong. This is also wrong. D number, CAMP level false. No, this is wrong here only, right? Not CAMP level false, CAMP level will rise. Okay, so A number is the correct answer. Okay, this is a simple question actually, but we should know the positive regulation, otherwise we are not able to answer. Okay, 21. Which combination of the following statements with regard to the gene expression is true? Okay. So, first number, heteronuclear RNA represents contiguous segment of the genomic DNA. Okay. Heteronuclear RNA. Actually, they are talking about HNRNA, something called HNRNA. Okay, heteronuclear RNA. Normally, these kind of RNA are synthesized in eukaryotes. Okay, represent the contiguous segment of the genomic DNA. Okay, this is correct actually. Okay, Q. UTRs are a part of heteronuclear RNA but not of mRNA. No, this is also the part of mRNA. UTR, untranslated region. UTR means untranslated region. UTRs are present at the 3 prime end as well as the 5 prime end of the mRNA also, right? They are present on the HNRNA, of course, but also present on the mRNA, okay, untranslated region. Okay, so this is false, okay, because they are mentioning not of the mRNA, so this is false. R, UTRs are part of exons, okay, UTRs are part of exons. No, UTRs are not part of exons. UTRs are not a part of exons, right? The part which are there, UTRs are the part which are there in the introns actually, okay? But they are along with the mRNA, okay? UTR, untranslated, they are not translated actually, so they are not part of exon. S number, I'm sorry, just a minute. UTRs are part of exons, of course, they are part of exons, not introns. I'm very sorry. Okay, UTRs are part of exons, right? But they are not translated actually. They are transcribed, but not translated, okay? But they are part of exon. This is correct. R number is correct. Translation start codon must be in the first exon. First exon. Translation start codon must be in the first exon. No, this is not correct actually. Why? Translation start codon, they are, you know, after some distance of the UTR, okay? Otherwise, translation process won't be supported, okay? So, translation start codon must be there after few codons actually, right? Few triplet codons, means after UTRs, the translation start codon would be there. So, P is correct, Q is incorrect, R is again correct, right, and S is incorrect, right, S is incorrect. So B number choice is the correct answer, right, because this is also correct, first number is also correct, B is not correct, R is correct, okay, S is incorrect, okay, so B number is the correct choice, okay. Okay, now assuming that the level of glucose is low. Okay, again, this is the positive regulation, case of positive regulation. Always keep in mind, positive regulation is very important, okay? they are asking question many a times. In CSIR-NET, they are asking mostly questions from the regulatory level, okay, regulatory level as well as the from the mutation level, okay. Almost every year they are asking two or three questions. Glucose is low. A mutation in the repressor associated with the lack of operon of E. coli, which prevents binding of the repressor to allolactose, should be result in. Okay. See, assuming glucose level is low, a mutation in the repressor associated with the lack operon, glucose level is low, a mutation in the repressor associated with, okay, repressor mutated, mutation is there in E. coli, which prevents the binding of the repressor to the allolactose, should be result in, okay. Now you got the question. Constitutive expression of the lac operon genes. Constitutive expression. So level of glucose is low, right? Of course, the expression will be there, right? Because level of glucose is low, so switch on. The operon is switch on, right? But second portion is mutation in the repressor associated with the lac operon, and which prevents the binding of repressor to the allolactose, right? Allolactose won't bind to the repressor, so repressor, tetrameric repressor will bind to the operator region, so it won't constitutively express, right? So constitutive expression won't take place, so this is wrong, okay? Lack of expression or reduced expression of the lac operon genes under all circumstances. This may be correct, okay? This may be correct. We'll read the third question, third choice also. Expression of the gene only when the lactose is present, okay? Not always, actually. Expression of the gene only when the lactose is present, not necessary, okay? Because this is correct, but if we compare the B choice, lack of expression, okay, lack of expression is also there, right? Because glucose is there, but low level of glucose is there, right? Or reduced expression, this may be also possible, right, of the lac operon gene under the under all circumstances, right? Because repressor will bind to the operator region, so operator region is blocked, okay? So lack of repression, reduced repression means glucose level is low, so positive regulation always exerts. So reduced level of expression is also there, okay, under all circumstances. So this is more correct, actually, B number. D choice, expression of the, so this is wrong, actually, C number, okay? Expression of the gene only when lactose is absent, okay? No, this is entirely wrong, actually. This is partially correct, but as compared to the second choice, this is not very correct. So B is the most suitable, actually, right? C is also correct, but B is the most suitable answer. So correct choice is the B answer, right? So here, see, lack of expression, of course, because repressor will bind to the operator, and another portion, reduced expression, because glucose is there, right, at the low level, so the expression by the positive regulation will take place. So B number is the correct answer, okay? All right, okay. Now 23rd, we should go now a bit quickly. So what phenotype would you expect for a mutation that eliminate the tetramerization of the lac repressor? So this is very simple question. So recessive and constitutive, right? Recessive and constitutive. This is very simple question. Phenotype. Okay. 24. Which statement are true about genetic control in prokaryotes? Okay. P number is RNA polymerase must bind to the promoter on the DNA to begin RNA synthesis. Okay, this is correct. Most gene expression is regulated at the level of translation. This is not correct. Transcription is the favorite site, right, at which the gene regulation took place. So Q is incorrect. Q is wrong, right? So Q is wrong. R, an active repressor protein, keeps RNA polymerase to form binding to the DNA. This is also correct. Repressor control gene transcription by binding to the operator. This is also correct. So Q is wrong. R is correct. S is correct. P is correct. So C number is the correct answer. Okay. Okay, this is last question. This is last question, but good question. A strain of E. coli has following genotype with respect to the lac operon. I minus means no repressor formed. O plus, Z plus, Y minus, A plus. Okay. This strain will, A number, produce permease only C. They are not producing the, repressor. So always the operon will be switched on, right? So produce permease only, no, not permease. It will produce, produce beta galactosidase. It will not produce permease. So this is not correct answer. So B number, not produce beta galactosidase is if lactose is present in the medium. This is also wrong. Okay. C number, not produce permease. Okay. Not produce permease. Of course, Y minus it is. So irrespective of the presence or absence of the lactose in the medium. Okay. This is correct. Produce transacetylase only when the inducers. Okay. No. It won't because no such. It produces transacetylase only when the only when inducers. No. Not inducers. It can produce. So C number is the correct answer. See friends, we have a couple of questions. We solved the couple of questions. We gone through the theoretical aspect. Okay. Now, just I have a few suggestions to you. Try to solve more and more questions. Okay, and try to set your strategy for the NET exam. Okay, not only solving the question will solve the purpose. Okay, it will also the matter of strategy. You set your strategy, then only you can crack the NET. Okay, so thank you very much for listening, and thanks a lot, and all the best for your exam. Thank you.
Vande Gujarat.